when we're talking about solutions and whether things dissolve or not, it's all about IMFs still. The IMFs between the solute and the solvent. So when we think about this, we kind of want to list our IMFs present in each of these while comparing which ones would be stronger, how strong they would be. Water, we know, attracts to other water molecules with dispersion dipole and, most importantly, hydrogen. This, which is methanol, attracts to other methanols with the dispersion dipole and also hydrogen. This molecule is bigger. It has more electrons, so stronger dispersion. It has a little bit of polarity here, but only some of the molecule is polar, so that's less significant. It does have the OH, but out of the whole surface area of the molecule, very little of it would be able to hydrogen bond. When we then think about our solution, we're thinking about what these things have in common. Well, both of these had a perfect overlap in terms of dispersion, dipole, and hydrogen bonds. And water can hydrogen bond significantly here, and this part can significantly hydrogen bond to the water. With this molecule, we have dispersion between them, we have dipole between them, and there is some hydrogen bonding. But water can only hydrogen bond on a very small percent of my atoms. And this can only, a very small percent of the atoms here can hydrogen bond to water. So if this were drawn out, it'd be a little bit more visibly obvious, but we can also see it from the formulas. So understanding all of that is how we know that the CH3OH would dissolve more completely in water. So there's our answer. Both do have some polarity. Both are capable of some hydrogen bonding. As described, a lot of the bigger molecule is nonpolar. We've got six carbons in a row, and they only have hydrogens on most of those. That nonpolar section forms a dipole to induce dipole attraction with water. There still is attraction between nonpolar and polar things, but that attraction is not as strong as the attractions that water has to itself. So that's why we don't see it dissolve as much. The more hydrocarbon part we get in an organic molecule, the less of it, the less it is able to dissolve, or the weaker the IMFs. The next one asks about the sulfate polyatomic ion. Would it dissolve in water or in hexane, which is nonpolar? So first off, this would probably be a part of a longer question that might ask you to draw the Lewis structure, determine the shape, and think about dipole moments. Well, sulfate is a perfect tetrahedral that is symmetrical. There is an oxygen on each side of sulfur, no lone pairs on our sulfur, so it is tetrahedral and there is no dipole moment on that. That may lead us towards a nonpolar answer, but we need to remember that sulfate, we don't really think of as polar or nonpolar, even though it has no dipole moment. We think of it as an ion. It is an ion with a full negative 2 charge, and if we're trying to dissolve it, it probably comes with some sort of cation, either a positive 2 charge or a few positive ones. Because it is an ion, that means it can form an ion-dipole attraction to water. That attraction is very strong, and it's likely going to keep it dissolved. It is stronger than water's hydrogen bonds to itself, and with enough of those ion dipoles, it can add up to be as strong or stronger than the ionic bonds the sulfate would form. Sulfate forms an ion to induced dipole with the nonpolar hexane. So once again, we're thinking about what attractions are between the things. Well, that is an attraction, but it's likely not strong enough to allow it to dissolve. Ion-induced dipole attractions have to be stronger than the ionic attraction sulfate would have for its cation. That is less likely to be true. The other challenge is hexane as a larger molecule, which you wouldn't necessarily know, but the hex in that is like hexagon, meaning six carbons. It has more trouble fully surrounding a sulfate ion. Water is such a good solvent because it's got that high polarity within a very small molecule, allowing it to hydrate or surround it very well. So even though we are symmetrical with no dipole moment, the important takeaway here is that it's an ion and those ion dipole attractions are strong. When we think about ionic compounds dissolving in water, many of them can. To dissolve, we have to break the ionic bond. We have to break the hydrogen bonds within water, and we have to make the ion to dipole attractions. If it does dissolve, then it happens. If it dissolves and heats up or dissolves exothermically, that means more energy is released by the formation of the attractions than is required when we break those apart. We could think of that in terms of bonding for other things or here for IMFs. That means we put in very little energy to break that ionic bond. So maybe it has weak ionic bonds. Or maybe it has very strong attractions between the ion and the dipole. This could happen a variety of ways, either by having lots of waters of hydration, lots of waters surrounding it. Some bigger ions have a whole bunch of waters that they can kind of pull in based upon their charge. But in either case, it's important to recognize we are releasing more than we are absorbing, and that comes from the attractions that we are making being strong and the attractions that we are breaking being weaker.